Power functions. The power functions are functions of the form y equals ax to the power of n, where a and n are real numbers. Here are some examples. Examples of power functions. Y equals negative 5x to the power of negative 3, y equals 4x to the power of 0, y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2, etc. Here is how to sketch the graph of power function. Trait 1. Part A. Sketch the graph of y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2 for x larger than 0. Part B. Find graphically the number of points of intersection of the curve y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2 and the line x minus 2y plus 4 equals 0. Here is the solution. How to sketch the graph of y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2? The first one is to choose some values of x and then substitute the values of x into the function y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2. Now we will have the table consists of the values of x and y. Here we choose x equals 0.5 and then by substituting the value of x into the function, so we'll have y equals 7.071. For x equals 1, y equals 5. For x equals 2, y equals 3.536, and so on. Now we have some points, and the points are pairs of x, y. Here is the list of the points. Let's say the point A is 0.5, 7.071. Point B is 1.5. Point C, 2.3.536, and so on until point G. Now we will plot all the points in the graph. So it will be like this. Plot all the points on the Cartesian diagram and connect them smoothly. That is the curve we are looking for. We have to sketch the graph of x minus 2y plus 4 equals 0 before we go to the intersection of this graph to the previous graph we have. Fortunately, this one is the line equation. What does it mean? For any line, you can choose only two points. Usually, we have x-intercept and y-intercept. So for x-intercept, y equals 0. So we have x minus 2 times 0 plus 4 equals 0, and then x equals negative 4. For y-intercept, x must be 0. Substitute it into the line equation, we have 0 minus 2y plus 4 equals 0, and then y equals 2. So we have two points here. The first one is negative 4, 0, and the second 0, 2. So let's say negative 4, 0 is point H, and the point I for 0.2. We plot the point H and I and connecting the two points, and this is what we call the straight line. From the curve y equals 5x to the power of negative 1 over 2, which is this one, and this line, we only have one intersection, which is here. Exponential functions. The exponential functions are functions of the form y equals a to the power of x. The value of a and the value of x must be real numbers. And here are the examples. Y equals 2 to the power of x is an exponential function. The other one is y equals 7 over 3 to the power of x. The other one, y equals 0.8 to the power of x, etc. This is an example of how to sketch the graph of exponential function. Try 3. Draw the graph of y equals 3 to the power of x for negative 3 is less than or equal x is less than or equals 2. So here is the solution. For y equals 3 to the power of x, then choose some values of x from the interval of negative 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal 2. Now we have the values of x and substitute the values of x to the function of y equals 3 to the power of x. Here's the table showing the value of x and y we have chosen. For x equals negative 3, substitute the value of x into y, so it will be y equals 1 over 27. For x equals negative 2, y equals 1 over 9. X equals negative 1, y equals 1 over 3, and so on. We obtain the points A, B, C, D, E, F based on the table. Plot all the points on the Cartesian diagram and connect them smoothly. That is the curve we are looking for. Natural exponential function is an example of exponential function itself. The form is y equals e to the power of x. E is an Euler number and the value is around 2.718 and so on. Example, try it for the mass mt in grams of a piece of a radioactive substance cobalt 60 at time t years is given by mt equals 8 e to the power of negative 0.13 t. A. Find the present mass of cobalt 60. B. Find its mass after 5 years. Here is the solution. For part A, MT equals 8e to the power of negative 0.13t given by the question. Because it is the present mass of cobalt 60, so it means that the present mass equals m0 or t equals 0 here. So substitute the value of t equals 0 will give 8 times e to the power of negative 0.13 times 0 or 8 times 1. 8 times 1 is 8. So it will be 8 grams. For part B, mass after 5 years equals 8 times e to the power of negative 0.13 times 5. By the calculation, it will be 4.18 grams. Logarithmic functions. Definition: y equals logarithm of x to the base of a if and only if x equals a to the power of y. When x is positive, a is positive, and a is not 1. Example: 8 equals 2 to the power of 3, and in the logarithm form, it will be 3 equals logarithm 8 to the base of 2. Once again, this is the exponent form and this is the logarithm form. In both exponent form and logarithm form, 2 are the base of each form. In Indonesian version, 8 equals 2 to the power of 3 can be changed into the logarithm form to be 3 equals logarithm of 8 to the base of 2. The base of 2 is on the left of logarithm. Example, try it 5. Without using a calculator, evaluate the following. Part A, logarithm 125 to the base of 5. Part B, logarithm of 10 to the base of 0.1. Part C, logarithm of 1 to the base of 7. Here is the solution. Part A, let y equals logarithm of 125 to the base of 5. Based on the definition, we will change the logarithm to be the exponent form. So it will be 5 to the power of y equals 125. Since 125 is 5 to the power of 3, so we'll have y equals 3, and then the logarithm of 125 to the base of 5 equals 3. Part B, let y equals logarithm of 10 to the base of 0.1. Based on the definition, 0.1 to the power of y equals 10. 10 to the power of negative y equals 10 to the power of 1. So from here we have y equals negative 1, and in the conclusion, the logarithm of 10 to the base of 0.1 equals negative 1. For part C, let y equals logarithm 1 to the base of 7. Based on the definition, we have 7 to the power of y equals 1, and because 1 is 7 to the power of 0, so we'll have y equals 0. What does it mean? The logarithm of 1 to the base of 7 equals 0. Here are some additional conclusions for logarithm. The logarithm of a to the base of a equals 1. The logarithm of 1 to the base of a equals 0. To make the calculation easier, we have some laws of logarithms. Number 1, logarithm x times y to the base of a equals logarithm of x to the base of a plus the logarithm of y to the base of a. We call this letter product law. Number 2, logarithm of x over y to the base of a equals logarithm of x to the base of a minus logarithm of y to the base of a, and we call this quotient law. Number 3, the logarithm of x to the power of n to the base of a equals n times logarithm of x to the base of a. We call this power law. Number 4, logarithm of x to the base of a equals logarithm of x to the base of b over logarithm of a to the base of b. We call this later change of base law. Example, try 6. Evaluate each of the following without using a calculator. Part A, logarithm of 9 to the base of 6 plus logarithm of 4 to the base of 6. Part B, 1 over 3 times logarithm of 8 to the base of 7 minus logarithm of 14 to the base of 7. Here is the solution. Part A, logarithm of 9 to the base of 6 plus logarithm of 4 to the base of 6 equals logarithm of 9 times 4 to the base of 6 based on the product law. And after that, we will have the logarithm of 36 to the base of 6. Because 36 is 6 to the power of 2, so this will be logarithm of 6 over 2 to the base of 6. Based on the power law, we have 2 times logarithm of 6 to the base of 6. Since we have the logarithm of 6 to the base of 6 is 1, so it will be 2 times 1 equals 2. Part B, 1 over 3 logarithm 8 to the base of 7 minus logarithm 14 to the base of 7 equals logarithm 8 to the power of 1 over 3 to the base of 7 minus logarithm of 14 to the base of 7 based on the power rule. Because 8 to the power of 1 over 3 is 2, then it will be logarithm of 2 to the base of 7 minus logarithm of 14 to the base of 7. Using the quotient law, we'll have logarithm of 2 over 14 to the base of 7. Simplifying this will get logarithm of 1 over 7 to the base of 7 equals logarithm of 7 to the power of negative 1 to the base of 7 equals negative 1. Example, try 7. Evaluate logarithm of 36 to the base of 8 over logarithm 1 over 216 to the base of 8. Here is the solution. The logarithm of 36 to the base of a over the logarithm of 1 over 216 to the base of a equals logarithm of 6 to the power of 2 to the base of a over logarithm of 6 to the power of negative 3 to the base of a. So using the power rule, we'll have 2 times logarithm 6 to the base of a over negative 3 logarithm of 6 to the base of a. From here, we cancel the logarithm of 6 to the base of a, and then it will be negative 2 over 3. Here is an example of how to sketch the graph of logarithmic function. Sketch the graph of each of the following functions for 0 less than x less than or equal 5. Part A, y equals logarithm of x to the base of 4. Part B, y equals logarithm of x to the base of 1.5. Here is the solution. We choose some values of x and then substitute the value of x into logarithm of x to the base of 4. You have to remember that the values of x must be in the interval given in the question. So based on the calculation, for x equals 0.5, y equals negative 0.5. For x equals 1, y equals 0. X equals 2, y equals 0.5. X equals 5, y equals 1.16. And then we plot all the points we get in the Cartesian diagram, and the sketch will be like this. The similar things happen for part B. You choose the values of x in the interval and then substitute into the function y equals logarithm x to the base 1.5. So we will obtain the points and then plot all the points in the Cartesian diagram, and the sketch will be like this. Stay at home, tetap semangat!